Good morning to you, Sylvester. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Top of the morning to you.
And the rest of the day to you, Sylvester.
Thank you. You're a grand lad.
He is, I can attest. Now, most shows don't last 50 episodes, let alone 50 years. Why do you think The Doctor is so popular and has, you know, stood the test of time for so long?
Well, my theory is that we're told there are only about six or seven stories under the sun, and mankind's genius is to take these stories and retell them. And one of those favourite stories is about someone coming from outside Earth, taking on a human form and fighting evil and trying to save, you know, mankind. Superman, religions, Doctor Who, they're all part of that wonderful story. And these stories have been told for thousands of years.
They really have, and this is a fascinating one. Your portrayal of the Doctor actually started out quite light-hearted and then became very, very dark. Was it your idea to give him the edgy edge? Edgy edge.
It was, yes. Edgy edge. I gave him even edgy, edgy, edgy edge. Four-sided. Yes, no, when I arrived, I hadn't seen Doctor Who for years because in those days it only went out once on British television and it was never seen again. And I was working in the theatre, so I never saw it. And I had a distant memory of it. And so when I arrived with my comic bag of tricks. But then when I got the part, I realised this is one of the great TV roles. And it was also blank canvas. You could do what you wanted. And I then started to realise that too much was known about the Doctor, so I wanted to bring back the mystery. And I also wanted to, in order to bring back the mystery, you had to make it darker and deeper and more three-dimensional. My grandmother, at the time, she lived to be 100. In those days, it was unusual. And you know, she talked about longevity in a kind of a weary sadness. And I thought, my Doctor's 850 years old. So I wanted to bring that in as well. And I also wanted to keep juggling the comedy. So I wanted it was like stretching my acting abilities beyond my means, really. But I hope I succeeded.
Yeah, and your Doctor had quite a bag of tricks. In fact, he could play the spoons. Let's have a look at that.
What'd you do that for?
It was your fault.
A bad workman always blames his fools.
Tools blames his tools.
That was just something that you did in real life, and they incorporated that into the script, isn't that right?
Yes, well, we did the outdoor filming before we actually did the studio part. And so after on the last night, the producer, John Nathan Turner, used to love to have a party. So we had a bit of a party, and Bonnie Langford, who was, you know, West End glory, she did her party piece, and my little piece was the spoons, so I played the spoons. And JNT said, oh, we've got to have that in it. And I thought he was joking, and then I get the script, and there it is. I get to play the spoons all over Kate O'Mara's front. My goodness, did they go.
Also read in real life as well, you have quite the secret kind of trait as well, that you are excellent at the twist, that you became quite famous for it in your hometown. Is this true?
Yes. I was in holiday in London in the steam age a long, long time ago, and Chubby Checker was coming to London. And the Evening Standard, the London paper, and they had a centre spread on how to do the twist. So I did I got this, and I took it back to Dunoon, and I took the LP, and I brought the twist to Dunoon. I was on a bus later, and someone sat behind me and said, oh, that's Kev, he's the twist king of Dunoon.
Do you still have the moves, Sylvester? We've got the music up. Can you still... Oh, there he goes. The twist king of Dunoon. And to think, Sylvester, your life could have been so different had you followed up on your dream of becoming the Pope.
Yes, that was... the thing is that I had actually left the seminary to become a monk, a Dominican monk. But when I got home, after all the forms had been filled in, they discovered I was a year too young. So I had to go to school. from the local school to Luton Grammar School was a mixed sex school. So very shortly after that, at the age of 17, decided rather than wear a skirt, I'd chase it instead. And so, you know,
It kind of brings us to the next question as well. 13 doctors, and the most recent is Jodie Whittaker, Doctor Who in a skirt. Yeah. Were you glad to see a female Doctor Who?
Well, yes, I was. I was delighted, but I found it very disturbing. I never thought I'd end up fancying the Doctor.
Well, there you go. You are completely charming. It has been so lovely to speak to you today. You can check out the current and classic episode.
I mentioned BritBox.
Oh, yes, BritBox.
Can I just say, today is actually Doctor Who Day all over the world. And today, also, BritBox arrives in Australia, and it's got all the greatest British television, BBC, ITV, Channel 4, and various others. And also, you've got 13 doctors all in one place.
Just that's what darkness. We love. I was about to do that little spruik, BritBox. You can head to britbox.com.au for a free trial. Sylvester McCoy, you're divine. Twist us to the break, can you?
Yeah.
Ha ha ha.